All right, we are live. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the stream. Today, we're going to be playing Star Wars Battlefront 1 online. I'm going to be streaming today and tomorrow since it's the weekend, so I figure we'll do Star Wars Battlefront 1 today and then Star Wars Battlefront 2 tomorrow. I want to play both these games, or at least stream both these games, multiplayer, since the Classic Collection released a few days ago, and I don't think the online's going to be that popular forever, since there's no, like, constant updates or a battle pass to grind like other multiplayer games. There'll still probably be an active community in the Classic Collection online for ages, but it probably won't ever be quite the population that it has today. So I want to stream this while it is somewhat popular. But yeah, today we're going to be playing Battlefront 1, which was the first Battlefront game I played, and we'll be playing it online, which is something I think I only ever really did, like, maybe once or something when, like, 5-10 years ago or something. Like, the amount of online I played before the Classic Collection was basically none. Because I didn't have Xbox Live back in the day when this first came out, so. Let's see, I just want to take a quick peek here. Now, I think for multiplayer settings, you go in here. This is the great stuff. I just wanted to see. There's, for those of you who don't know, the official servers for Battlefront, at least at launch here, have a measly 33 tick rate and stuff. Which for context, I think CSGO official servers, they at least used to have like 60 tick. And professional players would always prefer 120 tick. So, yeah. I don't know why it's only showing two games here. There are more than this, I know for a fact, because there's always people hosting their own games. But, yeah, I guess we'll start off with this one. But yeah, the official servers, unless they've changed them in the past day or so, are only 30 ticks, so the online on official servers isn't great. If we are able to later, we will switch to a community hosted one, and hopefully they'll just sort of say, hey, this is 120 tick. I know people playing Battlefront 2 have done that, so I'm just getting set up on my tablet here. No, wrong page. But yeah. I don't know why it's only showing two servers. Again, you can host your own whenever you want. Maybe there's an update or something. They have changed some things about the multiplayer server side since the game launched. Supposedly they have made it a bit better, but we'll see. Oh, you know what? Shoot, I forgot to enable streamer mode. I mean, it's not really going to do much if there's only, like, two games online that are just showing in the browser, but well, we're not gonna be able to do much here. 200 enemy tickets versus 15 for us. I also will say this, I am more used to playing this game on Xbox because, like I said, I played it growing up on Xbox, at least the single player. Like I said, I didn't have Xbox Live when these games officially, you know, were, you know, still had online on Xbox. And then years later, I would rebuy them on Steam, but I haven't played a whole lot on Steam, especially Battlefront 1, because Battlefront 1 always had some weird issues on PC that don't appear to be the case in the Classic Collection. Like, if you had a frame rate higher than 60, the tanks would just go wild. I think, for Battlefront 2, at least, the menus... would resize your windows and everything. And the only way to fix that stuff was with some community-made quality of life mods. I wonder if they changed the tick rate, because this does feel a lot more responsive. Like, before, it didn't feel that great at all. But here, it feels like my shots are connecting more. And I'll say this, 120 tick servers in this game sort of feel like what you would expect a game this old to feel like. Oh my goodness. Obviously, I'm probably not going to do that great here. We're losing reinforcements. Because if the AI, or the opposite team, has humans on it, it's a bit tougher than the bots that barely move. I know on Xbox, the somewhat meta thing here is to use, like, the engineer and stuff. Oh my goodness. Because that way you can charge up your shot, and then if you do hit someone, they're basically almost dead. And you can just sort of hold the charge indefinitely. Aww. I wish you could see how much health they have after you die. The droidicas. You know what? Let's try sniper. The one thing that is really cheesy on this map, if you can do it right, is you can definitely spam orbital strikes. Like, this was a thing in single player, and yeah, it's a thing in multiplayer too, which is ridiculous. I'm half surprised that, like, people aren't just spamming orbital strikes and mines. Here, I'll take care of this droid again. So cheesy. But yeah, this is especially useful on Mos Eisley and like tighter maps with like a skybox. Oh, that's so cheap. I love it. To be honest, this is the sort of stuff I would do in single player back in the day. Hey! Get a few cheeky shots out there. Aiming is so much better in this one. Yeah, that's the other thing about multiplayer too. We got Tech Shack. At least on PC. I don't think that's a thing on consoles. The thing is that, oh my god. Friendly fire is obviously off, because for a multiplayer game online, you don't want people to just kill each other and spawn. Oh, I'm dead. He finally caught on to me. Maybe if I hide behind here. It's so funny that it affects your teammates too, and they just go flying off to the side. Oh, well, I started flying. But yeah, I did this in Mos Eisley the other day. Went 40-0 just from spamming these orbital strikes. Ah, oh, they got the droid. No! I need my ammo droid to keep feeding the orbitals. Hi. Too late. Oh, that's so cheap. Here, I'm just gonna destroy their, If it'll break. Oh, there's a droid right here, right? There we go. Yeah, I wonder if they changed the tick rate. I certainly didn't see people saying how good the shooting was before. But this does feel good. They must have changed it or something. Or maybe rolling out an update. Aspire did post an update saying that they are working on it. Which people basically just trashed on for no reason, saying, oh, look, I don't even know why they were trashing on it. They were like, oh, it's a terrible response or whatever, but I don't know what else they could say other than, like, they're working on it. It wasn't ideal before, and they were working to fix it. That's basically what they said, and people were trashing on it because it wasn't good at launch. Hey, Hyper. Donk is right. I could stand next to... Hi. I have an orbital. It's so broken. I don't know why people aren't abusing this more. You can just get unlimited orbital strikes from just sitting next to a Donk droid. Battlefront 1 definitely has its quirks. Come on, get over. So how's the server coming on? I'm assuming you mean the Clone Wars RP server, or Gary's mod. I want to clarify that for anyone watching this later on VOD. Well, we haven't, as far as I know, we haven't gotten it yet. Which, I can't really work on it until, Wes buys it and gives me access to upload stuff and things. No, they destroyed it before I could orbital. Yeah, that's the other thing. You can just go as like a guy with an RPG and just one-shot everyone. Well, the droidicas are a bit harder, as you can imagine. We're actually making quite a comeback here. Come on, pull out the mines! I should just pull out the mines ahead of time. Yeah. That's one of the quirks I've talked about, like... I set my change secondary thing to scroll down, and sometimes it doesn't always do that the second I scroll down. I did not die from that. Hello? There we go. I think it's a lot more prevalent in Battlefront 2 servers. Wait, is that... I get two rockets before reloading? I don't think I knew that. Stop spamming at that door. The mines also don't glow immediately after you place them like they do in Battlefront 2. The mine drop. Oh. It's so cheesy, but it's so fun. Even when you're being blown up by someone who just drops a mine and then blows themselves up with no friendly fire. What you gonna do about that mine, Droidica? Gonna do about that mine? All back in here, I'll place more mines. Hey. Yeah, there's... Oh my goodness. That's disgusting. I really want to play online on Kashyyyk Docks. That way you can just sort of be on the top of the top platforms and then just toss orbital drones off the side. Bespin, not really a thing here. We're probably going to get a lot of people strafing us in ships. Also, unless I need to rejoin, I don't think streamer mode did anything. You might need to join a different server for that to apply. But it's fine. Oh.
We've lost the command post. Our reinforcements are being depleted.
Oh yeah, in Battlefront 1 you could also just be a droidico right off the bat. I don't know how... It's E, okay. E to go roly-poly mode. I mean, look at this. Ah, oh, it's so ridiculous. And that was a droid ship just flying in there. Depending on what side we are on, we might need to go Rocket Trooper to take out some turrets. On one of the sides, there's... The turrets are in a perfect spot to, like, spawn camp. Maybe not spawn camp, but... Oh, that might be our side. You can shoot down here with that turret. Let's just spam roll to go a little faster. Turn yourself into a roly-poly without being in one. How did they not kill him? I'm so used to just spawning instantly like in single player. I honestly didn't even know that was really a thing in multiplayer for this game. Let's drop some mines there. Oh, I hit him! Nice! Well, sniper. Can't really do much about him from here. I don't think you're shooting over the edge. Yeah, sometimes I have to like scroll down 3 or 4 times just to be able to get to my mines. Yeah. It doesn't always register. Oh my goodness. Yep. That's so cheap. That's Battlefront 1 for you. That was not anywhere near close. Where'd I get shot from? It didn't even, like, turn to look at whoever shot me. Eh. I just tried to dive in there and place some mines. Destroyed their health good, and if it just so happened to, you big snipers, if it just so happened to hit someone on the way directly through their base, then that would have been a bonus. Love the 10-second respawn times. At least they're not like upwards of 14 like in TF2. So deformed when he crouched. Oh. Yeah, some of the sniping shots feel really delayed. I'm not sure if it... If all that matters is what I see, or there's like some server stuff too. Like, does it matter, like, if I just, is there like lag compensation like in TF2? I have no idea about that in this game. Capping. I don't know if it's possible for me to see the names of players. Alright, there's a little. A little bit of a name. It was very faded. Jeez. Oh.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's hard to tell if the hit registration is just because of how old the game is. If it's lag. Or some sort of... Just some sort of weird networking issues. And then, of course, I'm not the best sniper anyway, so... They're still winning because they have two command posts behind us. After this life, we should probably... spawn back there and try to deal with that a bit. Jeez. Yeah, that's some rubber banding right there. That guy get on top. Well, that guy seems real, despite not having a name over his head. Oh, this is our only command post. Well, hey, that was someone. So sometimes when I zoom in, it shows their name. Sometimes it doesn't. I think it tries to only show it if they're within a certain distance, but... When you're sniping it... It makes it harder to tell if you're aiming at a player or not. Hi! I mean, that felt cheap, but at the same time, he's a jet trooper. Just flanking us, so... Oh my goodness. Yeah, see, even when they're standing still... Told you, I'm not the best sniper. Oh, they're in our... They're in our ships. I have, like, 2 HP. And, you know what? It doesn't feel like anyone's really trying to get the other command post, so... Oh my goodness. 12 seconds... I was just saying, at least it's not like 15 seconds, like, in TF2. Oh my goodness. Roly-poly mode, activate. Well, almost got me. I'm glad my teammate was there. I couldn't have done it without him. Ooh. Green is jerking so much. No! I didn't. I just fell off the side. Let me turn with the arrow keys. Don't. I think the problem is it's taking my mouse input and using that to turn. And so when I'm not completely facing a direction, it is weird. How much health does that turret have? Ow. That one guy had 100 kills. I wonder if that was the jet trooper or if he was strafing in the ships or something. I think we'll try to get a ship and flank them and capture their rear command posts. All right, it's inverted here. Yes, I'm taking their command posts already. Doesn't really look like any humans spawned back here.
We've captured a command post. Their reinforcements have been cut off.
There's a lot of guys over there. I don't know if those are real or people or not. Can I? Yeah, I wanted to do that. Take out their turret first. I didn't want to spawn down here. I mean, it's cheesy, but it worked. Did he really jump out? Get out of here. Where'd you come from? Again, it's cheesy, but oh, hi. Should have stayed in your ship. Let's place down some more mines. They'll never suspect. Bye. Again, is it cheesy? Yes. But is it effective in online? Yep. Sure feels more reliable than a blaster. Especially in 30 tick servers. This feels better than just 30 tick, but. That wasn't even a player. But sometimes with lag and stuff and ping, it's tough to hit people in these games. I think I just killed someone, never mind. Yes, I did. After it gets the hit marker, it takes a while for their body to fly around. And only when their body hits the ground does it really count as them being dead. Yeah, like, look at that. I'm not saying that rockets are necessary, but it's definitely a lot easier. Let's see, how many guys are spawning back here? If it wasn't a bot, then I wouldn't have been able to take it out.
You're leaving the battlefield.
I'm used to the flying controls in Battlefront 2, which allows you to, like, have turn assist on. Which basically means if you move your mouse in one direction, it'll keep moving in that direction. Until you move in a different direction, basically. It's a little more complex than that, but... Just a random guy here. Well, he accidentally laid down. And that put him, got him stuck in an animation to get up. I'm out of grenades. Why did I lose my grenades? They only got one command post left? Jeez.
We've captured a command post. We've lost a command post.
How do you teabag someone?
Thank you.
Well, that's a question I didn't think I'd hear in a... I don't think I've heard in ages. What? That didn't feel like it should have just outright killed me. Yeah, now we're abusing the turret that shoots down right into the hallway. Look at that, we could just camp their spawn. Well, not the best time to sit down. People don't realize, well, yeah, you can go prone, you need to go through an animation to go prone. No! The turret! Our own turret screwed me. It knocked me over. Knocked me over because it's an explosive, but it didn't do any damage. Oh, we win. Yay! Get a command post. GG! Yeah, the loading screen here is, like, the sound plays in slow motion, and I think the victory and defeat screen also do that in Battlefront 2 and some other miscellaneous areas. Hopefully that's something that can just be patched pretty easily. Everyone else had the same idea. Not today, Droidica. This is spam hallway right here. Welcome. That was a player too. I'd be so pissed. Jeez, we're just swarming the command post. Just put a mine there. I didn't think I'd die that quickly. Did I kill them? I think I killed that guy with the mine. Mine's OP. I think the only way you can get rid of a mine is to trigger it or use an explosive and blow it up. Spam hallway the second. Oh. Alright, I'll switch off explosive class for a bit. So that I'm not completely cheesing it this whole time. Ooh, you know what? Idea. If we go here, become a sniper, we can do another cheesy strat and just spam orbitals at the command post down below. I know this is super cheesy and not really fair, but... this is Battlefront 1 for you. I didn't need to do it yet. How do you survive? Why is no one else abusing this yet? I don't know. Oh, it comes in at a bit of an angle, so I think I need to essentially trigger it inside so that it actually hits the walkway. Like, if I detonate here, does it work? No. Wait, what? It didn't look like it worked. Jeez. Luckily, I'm not wearing headphones. Yeah, sometimes you can tell who's a bot and who's not just by how quickly they react to orbital strikes.
Enemy forces have captured a command post.
Your players react to orbital strikes a lot slower than the AI does because the thing is so small. This thing is like an umbrella. It's not really gonna help. Oh, they retook that place down there? Let's see if I can... no, not really. I can't make it all the way down there with my drone to do orbital strikes. Hey, my old mine that I placed ages ago blew him up. Well, infinite grenade spam. Pushing. I don't know why I'm at an angle like this, but... it does kind of work. Let's... I keep pressing Alt because that's the dodge button in Battlefront 2. Did we get each other? We did! Hey! I don't know where the hell the ammo droids are down below. But if you can... If we can get, like, an ammo droid below, we can detonate an orbital strike under one of the bridges. Possibly shoot him a bit that way. Is anyone looking around? I don't even know if those are players or bots. I would think bots would be able to shoot them faster.
We're losing reinforcements.
No. What do you think our chances are of taking this command post while they're distracted?
We've captured a command post.
Hey, Holiday Punch, how's it going? I didn't see your messages.
We've captured a command post. We've lost a command post. Our reinforcements are being depleted. We've lost a command post.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Enemy forces have captured a command post. We've captured a command post.
I know, obviously I know that's like from the sniper, but... Oh. Which is more intense, Battlefront 1 or Battlefront 2? In this particular scenario, I'd say Battlefront 1. Oh. How'd that not do anything to him? We have 50 tickets versus their 306. Okay. The thing about Battlefront 2 is Battlefront 2 has more mechanics. You can play as heroes and stuff. It's the only lobby not hacked. I'm not sure what they're talking about. I mean, it wouldn't surprise me if people have hacks already. I don't know how I didn't die.
Take cover.
Thing is, would hacks even be that good in this game? I mean, basically, all the guns are projectiles. Oh, that was a mine. And mines and explosives are very powerful with them. So, I'm not sure hacks would really help. I guess you could use some sort of like prediction thing. If this is platforms again. Okay, no, this is just Galactic Civil War. I'm tired of Bespin. Give me another map. Give me Kashyyyk docks. Well. Do we not have an ammo droid on this side? That's unfair. That guy went flying. Let's roll and place mines. That was, I didn't even get hurt there. I'm still alive. Oh, that's so funny. So a rebel triggered my mine, and since it was my mine, I didn't get hurt by it. So I just fell off the side. And the only damage I really took there was fall damage. I ended up going across the entire map. If there is already cheating in this game online, oh my goodness, then it basically already verifies my decision to get this game on Xbox and Switch as well. People are like, "Oh, I love how you're saying that cheating only happens on PC," and it's like. Cheating on consoles is basically using the keyboard and mouse in a controller lobby. Hacking in PC is significantly more blatant and easier to do. Especially if the console isn't cracked yet. If the console is cracked, then... It can be pretty easy, but... Roll and place mines! Roll and place mines! Roll and place... so cheesy, I love it. Towards new tubing. That's Battlefront 1 for you.
We captured a command post.
I mean, it also happens in Battlefront 2 online, but.
Well.
That was definitely a bot. It's weird, I'm used to saying bots to refer to, like, TF2 bots that are, like, cheating bots. I'm dead. That was a really well-placed grenade. Engineer in this game isn't that great. I like the engineer in Battlefront 2 with the shotgun a lot more. And the Battlefront 2 shotgun engineer actually feels a lot more consistent than regular blasters, so... Not only do you have better projectiles, but... It also feels better. I wish those legs were up. Ow. It's not a phase, Mom. I identify as a Wookiee. It's not a phase. I tried to make a cool joke there with the class he was playing, but... Didn't mean to throw that. We can snipe off here, I guess. Just make sure I don't get flanked here. Battlefront 2 online also makes the bots and spies a lot more viable. The bots can detect bots and spies a lot more than regular people. Doing pretty good though. This is a interesting command post layout. I don't think I've seen the AI achieve a layout like this, where we're all on one side. Usually one side tends to like the lower areas. Take it.
We've lost the carbon freezing chamber.
Ow. They're down to one command post? Jeez. The only thing about having this many tickets active is it's hard for them to make a comeback or change the course of the game at all. Jesus Christ, this guy just strafing in front of me. The Battlefront 2 official servers ironically have the opposite problem. They only have 100 tickets each, so games last 2 seconds. Wookiees have so much health. Looked like he was looking down when he was shooting at me.
We've lost the carbon freezing chamber. We've captured the carbon freezing chamber.
Oh, that was weird. Is there a place on the building behind that you can shoot from? It's nice seeing other people prone in this game. I don't think the AI really did it. I mean, hey, it's the only Battlefront game you can do it in, so... Need more ammo anyway.
We've lost the carbon freezing chamber.
I mean, I know it kind of sucks if you're in the middle of combat and you accidentally press prone and you get stuck in an animation. But I think it's better to get stuck in an animation than to have a game where you can just basically drop down at any time. That was close! So far away, ow. It looks like they're looking down when they're aiming at me. Oh my goodness, that guy looking up. It's like a spin bot, except I know that's just how the game is. GG. The other cool thing is on Xbox, at least, you can click on people's names and see their and get to their Xbox profile. Endor, eh? I wonder if people try to blow up the bunker. Maybe start off as a regular stormtrooper. We've also got the Ewoks on this map. I mean, for the NPCs, at least, it feels like the hit reg is significantly better. I think they must have updated the servers to use a higher tick rate. I mean, yeah, even that feels better than it did, like, a day or two ago. Stupid Ewoks. I'll take another look at the server browser after this. I walked her, Fred. Actually, wait, am I getting that with you? I think there's a second seat. Walker friend, come back! Yeah, it's like a co-pilot. It's a little janky, but you know what? The reticle is so high. I remember that being a thing with the original game on PC when that got released on Steam. And I think still to this day, it just has, like, a big issue with the reticle being high up. Yes. This is fun, though. Being the co-pilot in the vehicle makes me want to play on Hawk. Being the co-pilot in the walker. Get out of the way, Ewoks. Just like the movies. This is super powerful with two people. You're slightly elevated so you can see like above the trees and stuff. And you have basically twice the aim power because you have two actual human beings controlling it. Whereas in single player, you either give up the a regular seat to an AI, which isn't that good, or you give the co-pilot seat to the AI, which basically does nothing. Ooh, I got him. Ewok slaughter. Especially in the AT-ST. Shield bunker getting attacked. Eh. Well, that's the thing about the shield bunker. Is that we'll have it as long as it's alive. And they have to destroy it, which takes a long time and a lot of firepower to do. clear. Okay. Basically, the entire map's clear. Jeez. There's something in the trees here. Got him. Got him. Those are bots? Okay. You can tell they're bots because it doesn't show bot kills with a kill feed. Only player on player stuff. Or maybe if you get killed by a bot, but it doesn't show it when you kill bots, like it doesn't seem to play. Yeah, we gotta avoid the log traps. Again, something that the AI doesn't really do, yet any person with half a brain cell would think about. Got him. It also feels more powerful in Battlefront 1 than 2. Oh my god, the poor Ewoks. Oh. Well, I can't look at them to fire back. I can only look at a certain radius that this guy's looking at. Come on, turn! Now there are other ATSDs in the way. I guess we're going for this command post. No, I can't aim at him because you keep turning. Oh my goodness. Look at how many kills we got. 61. Well, if you don't face the threat, I can't shoot them. That was amazing, though. I love being the co-pilot. That way, letting someone else drive, and basically all you have to do is aim and shoot. Pretty sick. And that compared with having good hit registration in this lobby? Dang. Thank you. Ewoks. Get down. This is revenge for Ewok Hunt in 2017's Battlefront. To be serious, though, there are maps that are that do favor one side in this game, especially Geonosis. Like Geonosis on Battlefront 1 is very tough to win as the clones. You go for the Techno Union ships, your team dies while you're destroying those. You go fire on the ground, and the CIS just spawn at the ships and kill your guys. AT-ST blew me up and got me stuck in animation. Honestly, I don't really care for 2017 Battlefront 2. Something about the gameplay is just doesn't appeal to me. Everything feels much weaker. Like, I hate how weak the heroes are. 2015 I love. I still stand by my opinion that if 2015 had some, Alfred had some, like, had some more balance changes, or balancing, then it would certainly be a legendary shooter game. And it would probably have a lot more players still today. Hey, I got a Darth Maul trading card. Wow. That was a higher Ewok spawn. Oh, I think the Ewok spawn in here is still high. It's just that we killed them all in the AT-ST. Just nuke them.
Victory is imminent.
Are they talking about the new Ewok hunt? Yeah, I think it really depends on the new Ewok hunt in 2017 really depended on how good the players you had were. Like, if you had some good stormtroopers, then it was hard to lose as stormtroopers, and if you didn't, then you didn't. I'm gonna try to, oh well, do nothing because we won. 79 kills, jeez. And I went, I think that second guy must have been the AT-AT driver or something. AT-ST driver, I mean. Geonosis, A. Please be on CIS. If we're on CIS, then we're probably going to win. Clones are going to lose. No. Ah, what? Everyone already got in? Snipe some people with secondary turrets. Why your mom so bad? Need to shoot at. There we go. Barely got him. Overheat is so bad on this. Got him. This is a weird spot for this vehicle to be. Looks like it did. Are we going for techno union chips? This does quite a decent amount of damage to it. Jeez. I mean, to be fair, I guess really the best way for us to win is to destroy the ships and capture the command posts, rather than just directly fighting them. Oh. And the game crashed. RIP. I wonder if that crashed for everyone in the game. It must be online only, because I played this, I played that very same battle the other day and blew up the Techno Union ships, and it didn't crash for me then. Oh well, it'll give us a chance to see if there's more servers on now. Yeah, see, this is more like it. Still not that much, all things considered. I still think it's hiding some because, well, I don't know if it's... It must be hiding some of them, because just the other day there was so many more servers in, well, hosting servers. And I don't see any server on Geonosis, so... Either that server completely crashed, or... It's hidden. I mean, there's also not as many people playing Battlefront 1 because a lot of people like Battlefront 2 a lot more. Oh, well. Joined in right at the end. Dune C? Question mark? Please be Dune C. That would be awesome. Hey, it's Dune C. It's my favorite Battlefront map. Out of all the Battlefronts. The new ones and the Battlefront 2. Rebel. My speeder now. Just run him over. I don't like how the speeders have hull damage in this. They do one shot though. That was a good shot. Man, look at all these. Can't quite hit the player. You know what? It's probably couldn't hit those guys because of spawn protection. Hey, got her. I only say her because the rebel sniper is female. Oh man, the drifts in this thing. Run him over. And they really should enable heroes in the official servers here. I always played with instant action heroes on. It made it feel much more Star Warsy when Darth Vader and Luke were running around. Nah, I can't shoot you when you're that low. Oh boy. You gotta head back and try to... heal our speeder. It takes literally like half a second to fix. Rip. Where's this guy going? I think he was a bot, but still. What are they doing back there? I ain't never seen no bots go back there. Also, I just realized, do the Tuskens not have their own color, or did they take it? Oh, they took the Tusken Raider King. That makes more sense. That's why rebels are spawning at the Tusken Rebels base. They captured the command post. Duh. Worth it. But hey, that's why we're streaming this today, you know? I want to play Battlefront 2 or Battlefront 1 while there's people going online playing this game. Thanks for the free delivery. Rebel AI just giving us speeders. See me. Honestly, I didn't really care if I got that Wookiee or not. I just need to get out of there. Ow. Sergeant Salty, so that was a player. Okay, we just wait around at this command post and the rebel will deliver us a speeder in no time. Well, the bots are stupid enough to just snipe. A real sniper, though. Firing squad. So many guys. Oh, he's so low. He's so low. You can't play as heroes in this game. Sneak up behind the tank and oh, it blew up. Never mind. Yeah, this is also probably another reason why people are probably more so playing Battlefront 2 is because you can't sprint. I know a lot of people like sprinting. That helps the game feel a lot more modern. Being able to sprint. Can't possibly be anything bad. No! I almost made it to the homestead. There's a lot of planes and tanks going around. We need some anti-vehicle guys. Thank you. It didn't even destroy the speeder, it just sort of knocked that guy off. Place down some mines. And retake the command post. Didn't see the mine. Well, that takes care of him. Is that ours? I guess that's ours. Got him. Good as the Empire, but I think they've got too many extra tickets to lose. Hello? You don't. Neither of them realize they're walking next to each other. Wait, did I actually shoot that? I didn't mean to shoot my rocket launcher there. Oh, come on. I thought I was safe. No, don't go into the pit. We're doing so well, but we have so few tickets. For some reason, I can't destroy that. I thought those little turrets were one-hit kills. Downside of putting a mine running under my feet there. GG, that was close. Come on, Kashyyyk docks. Oh, we got another round on this map. Yeah, the slow motion audio acting weird is not ideal, but you know what? It's fine. The game is still playable, and hopefully that'll just get patched. Or someone will mod it back. I don't know if it would work on me. This is not the ideal place to be.
The separatists have cut off our reinforcements.
Oh my goodness. How did we get one of those? I'm just gonna spawn there and hope they don't contest it. Good. No. Well, actually, it turned out to be not that bad. That, we didn't get in. So many planes. Yeah, that's not an issue in Battlefront 2 either. Battlefront 2, there's no scenario where they can bomb you in planes. Thanks, engineer. I'm just here trying to destroy the planes. What? Yeah, you better run. Make our way up to the homestead. It's still our tank too? Stop tank theft. Oh. Aw, come on. I need that ammo droid. Is the one inside good? I really didn't want to blow it up. Thankfully, he panicked and left, but if anyone gets next to the ammo droid, they're kind of screwed. Danger! Oh, I got him. Barely had a chance to take off. I think the spawn protection saved him. We're still capturing him. I guess I'm driving now. Oh, that plane's gonna be annoying. You know what? Let's go right in there. Get the droidicas. This is just unfair. And now everyone else that dies here can't respawn. Yay! It's over, Clankers. GG, we brought it back that game. Tatooine, eh? I'm going to end the stream here, but I want to show the strat I was talking about earlier. Oh, especially since we're on the Rebels here. Just go sniper. Go to this little ammo droid in the corner and lie down. This is especially powerful as the CIS. Because the droid sort of blends in. And then just spam orbital strikes out this way. I think that was enough. Maybe not. You can also go up this little staircase here if the direct route is a bit too much. And there you go, you just spam that. If they get close, just go right out the door and trigger it immediately. And there you go. Easy kills. Oh, it's so OP. I mean, what can they really do? They just gotta... They just gotta charge in between orbital strikes. And again, the bots notice it a lot more than real players too, so... You can kind of tell who's a bot and who's not just by... If they shoot at your drone immediately. Yeah. You can tell. You can tell. Now. Yeah, you basically just do this the entire game. Until they either go in through the back side or the back door or the game ends. Oh yeah, I'm not going to finish this game. I just wanted to show that before we ended the stream here, since it just so happened to go to that match. But yeah, I'm going to end the stream there. We're going to be doing some Battlefront 2 tomorrow, which should be pretty fun. I think we'll do a little Hero Assault, but try to stay to Conquest for the most part, just because Conquest is the main mode. But if we try to squeeze in Space Assault 2, it might be a little too fragmented, but we'll see. If you're watching this on YouTube, like, subscribe, follow me on Twitch here. The music's on, so I'm not going to make a single penny off of this video. Any ads you see are from Disney. Or I guess the ad revenue goes straight to Disney, so... Yeah. Hit that like button if you are watching this later on YouTube. Otherwise, be sure to hit that follow button here on Twitch if you haven't already. Join the Steam group and the Discord to get notified of when I go live. And yeah, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow for Battlefront 2. Bye.